I like to get high and watch Christian television. Anybody else? A couple people. I like to watch the Faith Healers. And I watch so many, I actually have favorites. And my all-time favorite Faith Healer has got to be this guy, Benny Hinn. And Benny Hinn, he's very good at the healing. He's healing people left and right all day long. He's healing his ass off. But he himself is doing the most wicked comb over. Which, don't you think if you could actually heal people? Would you take 5 seconds to fix your own bald spot? I mean, if you could straighten my spine, that should be a snap. And I'm not coming down on the comb over, I'm gonna do it when my time comes. I'm just saying you can't be a faith healer with a comb over. It's like being a faith healer with a limp. Nobody's coming to your show. Hey, I'm here to heal ya. Ow. Line up, I've got the gift from God. Damn this leg. Bobby, get my Percocets. My leg's killing me. I gotta heal these pricks. I kid him, but I think that faith healing must work. Because Benny Hinn plays like 90,000 people at a time. They come to these huge stadiums. He just taps them on the head and they're healed. He's like, boom, I can see. Boom, little toe straightened. And I just want to go to one of those stadium shows so I can go up to him afterwards. Hey, Benny, great show. Listen, on the way home, why don't you stop by the hospital? A lot of sick people in there. Oh, that's right. You're full of shit. You know, I make fun of the religious, but I grew up Catholic myself. My parents were really Catholic, like they almost molested somebody, and they're hardcore. And I understand growing up religious. I was religious, and everybody needs something to believe in. But there's other things besides faith. I was watching the news when the Gulf oil thing happened, when BP did some nice landscaping down there. And they had this news report of these people in Alabama. They were out on the beach, and oil had been washing up on the beach in Alabama. And they did like a prayer chain. To help get the oil off the beach. And that's all they did, by the way. That's it. They didn't like rent a skimmer and then do a prayer chain, or put up buoys and then do a prayer chain, or get informed and vote correctly and then do a prayer chain. That's it. It's a prayer chain. And the reporter asked the guy in charge, he says, what do you want to happen from this prayer chain? And he said, oh, we want God to come down and take the oil off our beach. And I was like, yeah, if that doesn't work, why don't you call Aquaman? See if he'll help. It doesn't work like that. Prayer doesn't work like, you're asking God to suspend physics. Hey, if it works like that, could you pray to God that he suspends gravity for 5 minutes so I can get that piano out of my fucking basement? I was doing that joke one time in Cleveland. And I had a lady, there was a lady, I did that joke and I heard this real loud noise over here. And I looked and there was a lady putting on her coat. I don't know how you make noise doing that, but she did it. And I said, what are you doing? She goes, you're going to hell. That's what she said, just like that. And I was like, if you really thought I was going to hell, wouldn't you be nicer to me now? If you really thought I was going to burn in a lake of fire for eternity, wouldn't you be like, oh, you're going to hell? Do you deliver bad news like that to everybody? Do you go up to people in the emergency room after a motorcycle accident? You're gonna be crippled!